I'd like for you folks to go ahead and Google M16A2E3. Go ahead and Google that in the images section on the Google search page, and you'll see some pictures of an interesting M16A2 from Israel that was used by the Israeli Defense Forces, and I believe they're still currently being used in some capacity by the IDF. Basically, what they did is they took an M16A2, put a Harris-style bipod on the front, just like this. They put a rail mount on top of the carry handle. Then they mounted an ACOG to that rail handle using a quick detach mount, which resulted in the ACOG being pretty high off the gun. I mean, we're talking like 4.5 inches, probably closer to 5 inches as far as how high that ACOG is away from the bore line, the bore axis of the gun. To counteract that, enabling the shooter to have a good cheek weld, they put a nice size cheek riser on the stock so that way you can still get a good cheek weld. Now, when you look at the images off of Google, you realize, wow, it's kind of a funky looking gun. But the reason they did that was they wanted the capability of being able to take that ACOG off quickly and throw a night vision on to meet their missions. So I think that was kind of interesting. And when I realized that fact that, hey, they swapped that out, I kind of thought about it and said, well, granted, they didn't have anything better to work with at the time. I believe this was around the 90s era was when these things were really fielded. And they're still fielded a little bit, but I think they're being replaced by more modern. The carbines, the Tavor rifles, and some of the actual railed AR-15s. They're replaced. They're phasing those out, I believe. Somebody correct me if I'm wrong. But in any case, kind of a funky looking setup, but it worked. And I see how it worked. Now, I do have the parts to do that with this rifle. I got a cheek riser. I've got a mount. I can go ahead and almost mimic exactly what they had. But what I decided to do was go with kind of a simplified version of what they did. I thought to myself, well, there's no reason for me to have a rail mount on top of my carry handle. I have no reason to have a quick detach because I'm not going to be taking the ACOG off. So I left it on there. With the kill flash, the kill flash does inhibit my sight line when I'm using the iron sights. This rubber piece right here is inhibiting it a little bit, but I can just take this and move it out of the way real quick and I'll be just fine. But the ACOG is on the carry handle and I don't have the cheek riser, but pretty much the whole thought behind this rifle as it's currently configured is kind of a simplified M16A2 Echo 3. So that's kind of my thought process. That's one of the things that kind of drove me to get an ACOG for this M16A2. So you kind of understand kind of the motivation. I wanted something that was simple, but seemed to make sense. You know, I put the Magpul pistol grip back on just because I thought, hey, there's more meat to it. My hands are pretty big. So the better grip I have on the rifle, the more consistent trigger placement, all that good stuff, more consistent trigger pull I'm going to get. I left the bad lever on there because I like what the bad lever gives as far as one-handed manipulation, if it comes down to that. And then, of course, other stuff I kind of left on there. But Google it, check it out, M16A2 Echo 3. And it's kind of a neat setup. It's one of those AR-type setups that you don't see a whole lot. It looks stupid at first, but then when you kind of get an idea on what they were doing, it kind of makes sense. And that's kind of the core motivation for my current setup here. And some of you guys that's followed my videos, a quick note, you'll notice that this M16, or this AR-15A2 rather, it's not an M16, this thing has actually had quite a bit of configurations over time. And there's a reason I'm doing that. Not only is it fun, but there is a lot of people out there that say, man, I hate the A2 configurations. You can't do anything with them. Well, I think I've shown that you can actually do quite a bit as far as configurations. I've had different optics on there from the Citron, which I still have, by the way. I'll probably throw that on my 22 AR for fun, or I might just throw it back on my bolt action 22 rifle. But the Citron, I had an old Colt 4 power scope on there. I had a red dot on this rifle at one point, an aim point that was goosenecked on there on a gooseneck mount. I've had different handguards on it. I've had a different stock. For a while, I threw a collapsible stock on there just for fun. Different pistol grips. There's a lot of little things you can change on this rifle to change how it feels in hand. So if you got an A2 and you want to mess around, you certainly can do it. So just wanted to take a second first to just kind of tell you guys about the M16A2E3. Google it, check it out, research it. It's kind of one of those neat little rifles, I think. And just to give you an idea of what my inspiration is for this current build. So, all right, sorry for being long-winded. Thanks a lot for watching.